Michael Holt is a convicted right-wing extremist, currently in lockup at Long Bay Jail. Holt was sentenced in 2017 to a minimum of just 4.5 years for firearms offences after police discovered his private arsenal. The judge compared Michael Holt to Martin Bryant, saying he could be the next Port Arthur mass murderer. And Holt made no secret of his plans to kill. The neo-Nazi supporter wanted to shoot up a Westfield shopping centre in Tuggerah. Ahead of his planned attack, he sent out a slew of disturbing text messages.
I always fantasise about mass homicide when I'm in crowds and crowded places. I've had enough of this shit. I'm about to lose it. All these s*** need to get butchered.
Should we be concerned that there's a group like Exit helping someone like Michael Holt to come back into society after only doing 4 years in prison for wanting to essentially create a massacre?
I think you should be more concerned if there was no one there to help him and he enters the society with no one there. We will do our best to get him integrated. We definitely are aware of risk and we do whatever we can to mitigate that.
Michael McKenzie is just one member of Exit Australia, a network of former extremists, veterans and bad boys come good. Exit Australia's founder, Matthew Quinn, volunteers to work with Holt inside prison as part of an unusual arrangement with New South Wales Police.
A big part of this that people don't realise is de-radicalisation isn't a one-month quick fix. Michael Holt's been in there for 4 years. He might need another 6 years of help. At the moment, he's actually disengaged from violence and also worked with his family and friends and like rebuilt a support network for him as well.
Matthew himself was the ringleader of a violent far-right gang.
I used to just carry an axe and, you know, a couple of the other guys carried like sledgehammers. And then, yeah, some guys had like baseball bats with nails through it. Like at the start, we were like beating up other people.
So anybody that wasn't white?
Anybody that wasn't white, yeah. So I was planning to use that group to go and do an attack in the city and shoot all the Asians. You know, we started looking at purchasing weapons, automatic rifles. We had two guys making explosives. There's almost like an addiction to violence.
What does that feel like?
It just feels like drugs. You know, that's what violence is.
Violence that Michael McKenzie knows all too well. He went from street fighting as a teenager to the military, fighting on the front line.
I think there's a lot to be said for a lot that happens in the army, that there's a lot of broken people that leave. They destroy your personality to make a soldier. When you leave, they don't rebuild who you are.
Matthew and Michael refuse to publicly reveal the identities of the other members of Exit. All they will say is that the organisation primarily works to help people who've been recruited into hate groups find a safe way out.
The reason that all members of Exit can't be identified is for their own personal safety.
Is there any risk to you by doing this?
You have to be brave to make change. Yeah, I'm willing to take that risk. It can't be any worse than going to Afghanistan. I survived that. I'll survive this.
For Matthew, survival was about fighting back. He says he was violently beaten almost daily by bullies at school. The gang was his way out.
You were incredibly violent. You were hurting people. I mean, you were planning an attack to kill people at one point.
I didn't immediately just wake up and decide that I wanted to be a violent person. Violence was accused against me almost every day. The only thing that I knew to do was to do violence.
How did you go from being in a white supremacist gang to Matthew Quinn, who's sitting in front of me right now?
Yeah, there's a bit of a story to it, but, I was, like, on the way home and fell asleep at the bus stop and, like, another gang came and attacked me. And then the person that saved me in that, where I dead set thought I was probably going to die that day, was an Asian guy. So someone from that community that I, that we were attacking was the one that saved me.
Was that your awakening?
It certainly started to open up my eyes. You know, it took me out of that bubble that I was in. The biggest thing I think that changed me was that, and even including the Asian guy, was the people were compassionate towards me and then gave me like a different perspective on the way I was looking at the world.
In just the past 9 years, more than 200 people around the world have been killed in at least 18 white supremacist attacks, including the Christchurch massacre.
At 1:40, a gunman entered the mosque during prayers, the busiest prayers of the week. The gunman began opening fire with an automatic rifle.
Exit say they're monitoring far-right extremist material like this recreation of the Christchurch terror attack.
This is a recruitment video?
It's propaganda, and it furthers their cause to desensitise potentially new recruits, and it's probably the first instance of grooming them to committing an act like this.
One of many on the exit watch list at the moment are neo-Nazi groups like Blood and Honour, which takes its name from the Hitler Youth Organisation. Just months ago, Blood and Honour held a neo-Nazi music festival at a secret location in Melbourne. In 2019, Canada listed Blood and Honour as a terrorist organisation, and many other countries around the world have banned the group, but it continues operation in Australia.
Are you working with authorities or do you work alone?
We work alone as an organisation. But obviously, like, if we do see something that's an imminent threat, we have contacts within Home Affairs, and so we'll send that information across to Home Affairs.
Over the last 6 years, the Department of Home Affairs has spent more than $53 million on programs to counter violent extremism, but they won't discuss their dealings with Exit Australia. But Facebook, heavily criticised for not blocking violent material, has made a deal with Exit.
We launched a de-radicalisation program in Australia in partnership with Exit Australia, where we connect people who search for terms associated with white supremacy on Facebook to resources from Exit, focused on helping people leave behind hate groups.
Facebook's contracting to Exit Australia should be considered in light of criticism that was really directed at Facebook in the aftermath of Christchurch. We do need to sort of think with a critical light about whether it's contracting or Exit Australia is meaningful or whether it might play more of a token function, you know, a show of compliance with sort of public demand.
This is the site where Matthew and his white supremacist gang regularly met to plan violent attacks. It's the first time he's returned here since he left his former life as an extremist.
Kind of feels like ghostly in a way, but just brings back all those memories from childhood that I don't really want to think about.
You've said yourself that violence is like an addiction. What's to say you won't go there again?
There's no reason for me to go back to any of that pain or violence.
Have you forgiven yourself?
Yeah, I have. I do feel like a changed man. In a way, I kind of feel like a bit of a father figure. I'm able to, like, get in there and give these guys a second chance, you know, like, just be there for them and show them that there is another life out there.
Well, there are full statements from Facebook Australia and the Department of Home Affairs on our website if you'd like to follow that through.